Welcome back, peer structure traders, for another market analysis for the London session and potentially into the US session. Today is November 1st, 2021 here in Hawaii and will be November 2nd, 2021 in London. Today we'll be going over S&P 500, gold, and also oil, give you guys some of the levels that we'll be looking at. So again, if you guys do like these videos, please go ahead and smash that like button. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe. Any questions you guys got, feel free to pop them in here on YouTube. We would love to get back to you guys. But with that said, let's go ahead and jump into it. So we did have some nice downward movement into a main level of ours right around these 45.87 to 89s. And then we started to bounce from there. Nice one, two, and three touches. So triple bottom off that level. You can see we shot up to resistance here at 46.03 and then 46.0750 as the area of resistance up at the top. And you can see we're starting to come back down again. Do want to see if the market gets back down to this level of 45.87 and bounces again. This may be a nice opportunity to try to bounce and continue to move right back up into resistance. That's what I'll look out for first. If not, if we get down there, we just drop right through. Next level of support, 45.81.25, and then below that, 71, and then 45.60.25. So we'll see if we can actually get down to those support levels. If we do pull back, resistance here, 03.25 and or 07.50 as the next area of resistance. Those could be our two areas. If we fail to get through, we are looking for short opportunities right in that zone, 03 to 07. So we'll look out for that on S&P 500. Let's move over into a smaller chart here, take a look at what's going on. So you can see where we're currently at, moving right into these 45.95s. I do think that S&P will gradually start to pull down into this area of 92 into about 88 to 87. And then maybe get a nice support bounce from here. So that's what we're anticipating. But again, you can see there could be some micro levels between these areas. But again, ultimate target for me is going to be that main support down below at about 87. So we'll see if we get down there and get some support coming in. If we do, double bottom, maybe a nice opportunity. Look for a long, maybe a one touch. Could be just a one touch and go. So we'll see how it reacts off that level. If we get back up and rotate back up against these 46.03.25s. Again, that's our first area of resistance. And then above that, you can see our next level is going to be right around those 07.50s as the next level of resistance. You can see how we came up and we rejected this area and fell right back down. That's kind of what we're looking for right around these two areas here. Another rejection and then a nice push down lower. So we'll keep an eye out for that. Moving over into gold, let's take a look at what gold has for us here on the charts. So we did gradually climb into those 1796.2s. You can see rejected it one, two, three, four times and then fell right back down. But you can see holding a little bit of a micro level. I do think if we continue to fail to get through this level, next level below 87.9. And then below that 78 and 70.1 as the supports below. Resistance above 1801.6. So really not too much. We're just moving sideways. Let's take a look here at a smaller chart here on gold. So again, moving sideways right now, holding a little bit of a micro level. You can see this area right in between, right at this peak there, right around these 1791.8s. But chopping through this level, it'd be better for us to wait for it to exhaust here at 96.2. And then maybe get a short opportunity or come down below into these 87.9s, fail to get through, and then get a long opportunity right into the mid area. But if you're looking to try to take a trade right in the middle, that is going to be a little bit of a riskier one. Just keep that in mind. That's why I left the level off. It's better for us to try to look for the opportunities at the exhaustive levels. So we'll see if we can get that to happen here on gold. But again, not too difficult. Resistance here, 96.2, as we'll look for the short. 87.9 is where we look for the long right now. Above that, 1801.6 as resistance and 78 as support down below. Moving over into crude oil, let's take a look at what's going on. So crude oil had a nice support to the upside. You can see we went as high as right around these 84.86s and then started to travel back down. I do think crude oil may want to try to come back into the support of 83.69 and then maybe look for a nice bounce opportunity. If not, below that 83.26 and then below that could be our next levels of right around 82.33. So really not too much going on, but if we do get the support here, we could retest these 84.40s and then above that try to retest 84.86. now if we fail to get through these 86s, these 84.86s, this could be our nice opportunity for a short right back down. So keep that in mind. But as of right now, still bullish. So I do want to see how we react off those 83.69s as we come into the London session if we get down there. But that pretty much wraps it up for S&P 500 gold and also oil. Again, if you guys do like these videos, please go ahead and smash that like button. If you are not subscribed to the channel yet, please go ahead and subscribe. Any questions you guys got, feel free to pop them in here on YouTube. We would love to get back to you guys. With that said, if you continue to trade, make sure you guys trade well. You guys have a great night. Take care.